good?
You interrogated.
No, you look good. Take a look.
Talk now, because when you get back to class, you can't.
All right, yeah, grab your stuff, go back to class.
Okay. So just state your name first.
I'm Claire DeSarno.
Okay, Claire. And you were in the accident, actually.
Yeah, I was in the second car.
What was it like being part of the accident this year?
It was intense, a lot more intense than I thought. Like, right when we went under the tarp, I started crying immediately, like, real tears because of how overstimulated I was. I didn't think it was going to be so scary, but it actually really was.
Rubbing alcohol will also take off the stuff. Rubbing alcohol or your mother's eye makeup remover.
Very real.
Well, I've been involved in every 15 minutes since the first time we did this in 2010 when my kids were in high school. And I was able to actually speak to a bunch of the kids over the summer and see how this program actually affected them. And it was really amazing to see the long-lasting effect. This wasn't just an event that the kids had and then the next morning they come back in and they forget all about it. This really had a long-lasting effect. I heard stories of prom weekend where kids actually took the keys from other kids when they were drinking too much so they wouldn't drive. And they were much more aware of the dangers. They're always aware of it because it's taught in other areas, but I really feel like this program made a much stronger impact because you can see the tangible impact of your friend dying on a car. Even though it's all for show, it still has an impact. It has an impact on me today when I talk about kids that I've known, even though I know they're alive. But when you talk about losing a child, losing a friend, it becomes that much more real.
Yeah.
And it does have a long effect, a very long-lasting effect. And, you know, we can't fix all the problems in the world, but if we can change the lives of a couple of kids, and we'll never know if we did or not, but I really believe this program has had a positive effect on many, many dozens of kids over the years we've done this.
Slowly grab for the phone. Okay, not that slowly.
I don't know, like, just, normal face?
Just grab it at normal pace. Sorry about that. She was like, Stranger Things. Okay, action.
I think it'd be like for a good cause, especially with prom coming up, that like you want to make sure that you're being safe, and even though it seems like you wouldn't do it, like in the moment you might change your mind, so it's good, just like a public service announcement to like remind everybody what the consequences of your actions are.
And I've been in an accident involving a drunk driver, so like I definitely want to make sure people don't feel the way I did, people's parents don't feel the way my parents did, and just from personal experience make sure that everyone is safe and healthy.
Well, Mr. Changer came up to me and told me, he asked if I wanted to do it, and I thought it was a good idea just to raise awareness for something that I feel like doesn't get enough attention as it should. So.
How did you feel playing a drunk person?
It was weird. It was just different, I guess. It was kind of random.
You don't have any experience with
fun.
That?
I have no experience with that at all. It was a lot of fun. Just, we had fun, yeah.
Did you like swerving in your car?
It's not my car, and I did enjoy swerving in it, yeah.
Multiple of my older siblings did the program and had a good impact on them. And I think it's an important subject that a lot of people should be aware of.
When Mr. Changeo came to me about the idea to be in this, I was really interested because, like Sarah, it wasn't me personally, but my dad was in an incident when he was younger and hit by a drunk driver and he almost died. So my parents have always taught me never drink and drive, and never let anyone drink and drive if you see someone doing that. So I think it's a really important message that we can share with our peers.
I think, like other people have said, it's a great cause, but more so than that, I'm sort of interested in film, and I think seeing the production of everything has been really cool so far. Like the way that the guys get multiple different angles of each shot, and they make sure there's like continuity in what we're saying and what we're doing, so they really like capture the moment. I think that stuff is really cool, so yeah, it's been cool to see so far.
I chose to be part of this program because I feel like it was a good way to like bring awareness to what happens around prom time with like drinking and driving, and kind of just like showing our classmates what could happen if we were put in that situation, and just getting like everybody together to really like push the message out.
I think it's like a really good, like it has a good message, and like it's a good program to like tell people like how dangerous it can be, especially with like prom and stuff coming up.
And how has it been so far?
Pretty awkward, just like with the filming and stuff. It's not like something you would normally do.
How has the awkward conversation been? Was yours also the TikTok videos and the
No, we were in the drinking group, so it was like...
Oh, oh yeah, you were the one with the bottle of vodka.
Shane!
Hey, I heard you the whole time. I heard you the whole time.
Good job, brother.
How you feeling?
Hot, sweaty, and a pain. My neck is killing me.
What would you like to see some of the students get out of this ultimately? Or what are you hoping people get out of this?
I guess I'm hoping that they continue to be educated about decisions that they're making outside of school, right? Where we don't always have the ability to be looking over their shoulder or tapping on their desk. And I hope that the lessons that they're learning are things that are gonna stick with them and carry them through not just, say, prom weekend or graduation weekend, right? But as they embark on, you know, the summer months. And for those who are leaving us in June, as they continue in the next phase of their life, right? And so that they're able to continue to make good decisions based on data and based on things that they're seeing and learning. And again, and making good decisions when no one's looking.
It's a big question because there's so much to be learned from this. First of all, I hope they take it seriously, and usually they do. I was here for, I guess it was 3 years ago now that we did it, and it really had the desired impact. I'm hoping it will be the same. But aside from the message, obviously not to drink and drive, the consequences that it'll have, but just in general, to make good decisions and to really think about how one small decision in a snap second can really affect your life, whether it is drinking and driving or anything else really.
What would you like the students, especially the seniors, to get out of the every 15 minutes this year?
I think it's a recognition of the negative impacts or dangers of drugs and alcohol and getting behind the wheel of a vehicle. And we want them, certainly this is the time of year, to be very excited about prom, to be excited about our spring events, but we also want our students, while they're having fun, to be safe. And I think it's about responsible decision making and realizing that their decisions don't only impact themselves, but they could potentially impact others as well. So just really making sure they reflect and are very thoughtful as part of the decision making process.
What is one of your favorite songs right now?
Wow, that's a good one. I wish I listened to more music of late. I have three little kids at home, so I listen to a lot of their music. That's what's fresh in my mind, right? All the Disney songs.
High fives. Please. Can I get a high five, please? I'm sorry. I know it's old.
I know it's old.
Yeah,
I get some of that too.
Yeah, there you go. Thank you. Put your hands away, that boy.
Pull over.
No one else. So the program obviously is designed to influence and save lives. So if them being involved in this can change their mindset about drunk driving, we did our job. So.
Yeah.
Keeping definitely. Our kids safe is what it's about.
Okay, JJ, what was it like this year being a part of every 15 minutes?
It was actually pretty difficult, but I'm glad that I was a participant. It really taught me a lot about drunk driving and the seriousness of the incidents. And it really taught me like to be safe when getting into incidents like that.
Okay. And
How about you? Your name?
My name is Teddy Tinas, and when I first got asked to be chose, originally I didn't want to do it. Then I went home, I watched a video from a couple years ago, and then it really showed you how everyone's affected, not only the person who gets killed, but their friends, their family, and really puts into perspective how dangerous and difficult the situation is. So I'm definitely glad I did it.
So how did it feel today doing the every 15 minute scene where the police officers came in to notify you about the fake accident?
Well, it wasn't easy. It's probably one of the hardest things I've had to do. Any one of us could really be in that situation. So when my daughter volunteered, I was very hesitant. It's a very touchy subject. Mm. You know, we spend a lot of years on education, on drinking and driving and what not to do and what, you know, no texting and so forth, all these years. And it still boggles my mind that kids sometimes just don't even think. They still get in a car, they think by having one drink is not gonna have an effect on them. So as much as I was hesitant to be on camera, I felt like it was a good thing to do, you know, for the community.
Yeah.
And, you know, so here we are.
Okay. So one last question, and let's just get the honest truth here. Are you wearing the glasses so that we don't see tears? No tears?
I'm okay. I'm okay at the moment. I'm okay at the moment. But when we fast forward to the courtroom scene, I'm not sure if it will be the same.
I just want to say that this woman almost made me cry earlier because she got emotional. And, you know, I'm the kind of person where if someone cries, I have to cry too. So I'm hoping that she doesn't get too emotional later so that I don't cry. Because I like to look tough in front of my wife.
Me too. I'm going to try to hold it together, but get my point across.
But even if you don't, it's okay.
Yes, of course.
Emotions are always welcome here.
Well, because you want it to look realistic.
Yes, we do.
Of course.
So yes, so in that case, cry.
But not a lot.
Crying over here.
Off camera, we have an alliance member.
Crying
up.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you. Cut. How fun was it for you this year?
It was fun is an interesting word. It was a lot of running around and coordinating, but I have to say in the 10 years that I've been with the department, I haven't been able to be a part of the program, and this year I helped coordinate it with the Alliance and the other first responder agencies, and being thrown into the fire, so to speak, it was a really interesting take on it, seeing what goes into it and how it runs. And you know, it was a lot of hard work, and luckily I was able to work with everybody, and we all, you know, came together and helped each other out, and I think the output speaks for itself. I think it was great.
Well, it's been my third time going through with it as a parent and fourth time going through with it as a Municipal Alliance member. And I'd say every year you think you kind of, it's going to feel a little, you're going to be a little numb to it, but every year it kind of brings back the really raw emotions of what it would be like if, you know, we lost a member of our, you know, student body, or obviously even, you know, a member of my own family through a tragic accident. So it felt, it still has a very large impact. I think on the community as well as, you know, the student body.
Yeah. Could you imagine if they were doing this kind of program when we were in high school?
No, I couldn't.
Hi, I'm John Marciso. Hi, I'm John Marciso. You know, I'm always nervous about how the kids are going to come together and how all the moves. There's a lot of moving parts with every 15 minutes. And we have to keep our eyes on so many different things with the students, with the school, what the rules are, and then we have the emergency services, we have police and firemen and ambulances, and sometimes we have helicopters, and it's incredibly intense and But every year the kids really come together and they really step up, and they're always surprised when they find themselves crying themselves.
And what made, I mean, I know you love what you do, but what made you come back to it this year?
I'll do this for as long as people let me. I mean, I've done 16 of these, and everyone is special. One of my best friends was killed in a drunken driving accident. And when I was first asked to do this in 2010, I didn't know what to expect. And we've done 6 in New Providence now, and we've done 4 in Kenilworth, 3 in Madison, and 3 in Summit. And I mean, we'll do them for as long as they let us.
And is there anything you'd like to say to your co-director, John Pelham? Sounds like he's a pretty cool guy.
Yeah, he's all right. He's a Yankee fan. I mean, so I don't really want to.
Thank you, Joe. Okay, and tell the truth here. Did you stay silent all day?
I did.
Wow. What was that like?
It was very hard, especially because my sister's in some of my classes.
Was she egging you on, trying to get you to talk?
No.
Okay, she was supportive. Okay, great. And how about you? Was it hard not talking today?
It was very difficult, especially like the classes that I have like my friends in, like it was really difficult.
I mean, it was difficult, especially like in the classes with my friends, but I pretty much did for the most part.
Okay. And you, how difficult was it for you to stay silent today?
It was really difficult. I really like talking, but I think I did a good job. Like I tried to like not interact with a lot of people, but it was definitely hard when I was like, around my friends and everything.
Your friends were trying to get you to talk.
Yeah, kind of.
So this is my 6th time doing the Every 15 Minutes program. Okay. And we've been, so over the course of, at this time, 12 years.
Okay, and why do you continue to do it?
Because the kids love it so much. It's a huge undertaking for me, you know, for my end and everything, but every year, you know, kids sort of, they're very easy to recruit because they're kind of familiar with the program at this point, and so when they get to their junior, senior year, they're very enthusiastic about being a part of it. So it's gotten easier over the years to recruit 25 kids to be part of it, and then, once we're done with the program, invariably, a number of them will come up and be like, oh, thank you so much, thank you for letting me be a part of it. And so then I'm like, you know, they love it so much, so it's like, you know, why would I stop doing it then, right, if it means that much to them, so.
Man, camera's rolling?
Rolling.
Action.
Where do you guys want to get food?
Kind of feeling Chick-fil-A.
I'm down for Chick-fil-A.
I think we should get Chipotle.
Yeah, we probably don't have enough time.
We're on Chipotle.
I'm sorry.
We said-